Yeah, and you will hopefully get to see some because you will continue to cast into our next match.
Which Although I don't want to be a downer, but I don't think the next one is going to be quite as close.
Wow. Okay.
But I'm excited to see this next match because it's going to be, I think, really different from the last one.
Yeah, I think everyone believes that because we are seeing US with the number one seed go up against Austria with the number 16 seed.
Yes, literally the first against the last. Now, I'm all for an underdog story. Like, this
100%.
Is my favorite thing.
100%.
If Austria takes one map, I'm actually going to scream. I'm going to go insane and it's going to be very fun.
If that happens, it's going to be insane. But
all right. Okay, so we've just received the news that we're not going to do warm-ups for Austria. So we're just going to do a warm-up map chosen by the USA. And then we're just going to go straight in. And we have Estrella, Ptolpa, Tornado, and King Razor.
Spoiled little brat. I do not recognize probably a single one of the warm-up maps because most of them, like a lot of them are actually made for World Cup, but most of them are kind of like maps that are kind of not really. Yeah, they're memes and kind of, I want to say important, quote unquote, for the team. So, you know, if this is like a US thing, I have no idea what's going on. It might be a normal map too. It might be a normal map too.
If it is, wasted opportunity. And it is not.
I was going to say, this does not look normal.
While they warm up, I'm going to even nail the thing into the coffin again. Look at the qualifiers, all right? You go into the individual leaderboards. And you see that Sarit is first, Kulpik is second, Garsh is third, all right? But then you go... Then you go into the individuals and see Kulpik, for example, and he's top 10 in every single map he played. Top 7. In every single one.
90% sure my list.
That's what makes the US scary. They're not only competent in what they're good at. Some are, like Pandita. Pandita is very, very, like, singular skill, but at a level that is just not human. You take people like Kulpik, they're all-rounders with a specialty, but they're still all-rounders.
Yeah.
And that's, you cannot counter-pick them.
Yeah, that's, it's really crazy to me. And you know, the scary part is Pandita is actually getting into mid-speed slowly now. Like, I've seen him hold, like, I think a 99 on a 5 notes per second map or something, or maybe even faster. Like, that's just ridiculous.
It's not that Pandita is getting to mid-speed, it's mid-speed that's getting to Pandita. Like, it's becoming Ack.
He didn't choose the Ack life, the Ack life chose him.
Yeah, exactly. Like, pick one. As soon as Pandita can 99 it, can you even call it mid-speed? It's just Ack.
it's really crazy. So, you know, I'm really looking forward to where these players will stand, like, in a year from now. Because, like, things are moving so fast right now. Players are improving so much.
Wow.
It's actually insane.
Such a good score in Valentine.
You take last year's tournament. Like, there's no competition with this one.
No.
It's a whole nother level.
It has, like, the skill levels have changed so much.
Before
even like the mapping skill levels have changed a lot. I've watched a few maps like from the last World Cup just as like reminiscing, and I noticed like the mapping quality, man, it's so much better these days.
Yeah,
like the maps they play so much better. It's actually
so
insane.
Much better than I've ever done.
Also the pulling community,
definitely
the map pullers that put a lot of effort into it now, and even more than before.
That makes a huge difference.
Mostly because the community got a lot better at recognizing
my
tracking maps. That's
crying.
Part of the thing. Like,
don't cry.
People are very vocal about bad maps, and I think it's valid. I like seeing better maps, and so the mapping, map pulling team really puts great effort. They've been map pulling for 7 weeks at this point. It's really a lot of effort.
Yeah, and if like I thought, I've read on Twitter that it's not finished yet. So I think work is still ongoing, right? If I didn't miss that post by Koala.
Yeah, so we saw Ryasu win the role with a 97/1. Jeez. So they're gonna ban first. And hardware store, no!
It's gonna get...
Why does nobody make me see hardware store? It's the only song that we haven't seen yet.
Kings and Queens has also been banned.
Yeah. And Ahmed. Valid.
Hell above. Again,
hell above, alright.
Okay, so...
They're choosing a Seret map.
Yeah, which is, you know, Seret maps are pretty hackable. I think this probably falls into the mid-range. You know, it's a mid-speed map, but it's really hackable. I think like 97.8 or something is like the highest score on it currently, which is pretty insane for a map with over 8 nodes per second. Coolpix Green is different.
Yeah, it's been bugging me the whole time.
It's
There's
really,
always
very
one that's always one that's a little different shade.
Yeah. And there we go, getting started with the map.
Immediately straight 97s for everybody on the US team. Austria keeping a solid almost 96.
Yeah, Ria's doing really good, almost at a 97 too.
Yeah.
Ria's accuracy is also really strong. And at mid-speed, Ria is one of the best players too. But it's kind of like... Yeah. No, every player in the US is kind of half a percentage ahead still. Everyone is holding close to that 97.5. Saber a little bit above. Garsh missing, dropping a little bit, even as I was going to say that he was holding a similar accuracy.
Also, Rex has dropped to a 92.
Yeah. Is that 7 misses? Was that like a tracking issue, maybe? I'm not really sure what happened, because 7 misses is quite a lot. That usually doesn't happen without a reason.
Yeah. Also, when 7 misses and you're still on 93, that's probably one after the other.
Maybe that was just a gigantic lag.
Could be. Anyway, Garsh just climbing back up to a 97 after the miss. No big deal.
Yes, not a big deal. Estrella holding same accuracy as Kubik on this, which is really, really good. Saret slightly ahead currently. Pretty much on par with his current PB, which is at 97.74.
Man, it will never stop to amaze me. How the hell?
Yeah, it's really insane. It's also so fun to watch. It's really fun to watch. Because like the swings, they're so pinpoint. It's like they're like... bad cutting with Kubik, bad cut on that double. It's almost like if you watch it, it just looks like the swings are homing in on the blocks. Like, it's insane. It's really nice to watch.
I I'm subscribed to Saret. I watch all his videos, and every time, like, it's insane how every video kind of looks the same for that reason. Like, he's a machine.
Yes. So, currently, Austria doing really well, though. 3 full combos, and I think Ori's, like, I don't know, it was probably a lag. There was nothing aside from that, so they're playing really, really well combo-wise.
Yeah.
So Alpha not quite
Absolutely.
Able to hold that 96.
Holding their own with a 96 on this.
Especially Rhea is really good. Holding a 97 is extremely, really strong.
Yeah. Like, we've seen... I believe Gustav in the last map keeping like right above it, and Gustav is freaking Gustav.
Gustav is really insane too.
Man.
Yeah. Just... So this map doesn't really have anything that can catch you off guard. I think there's like one left-handed part in there, so I don't think we're gonna see two like. Nothing too much. I'm not really sure why Kubik is bad cutting, to be honest. That was a little odd. But there was another. Uni missed too.
Yeah.
Oh, Alpha too. Okay. There were a lot of misses at the same time. But in the end, it doesn't really make a difference, right?
Yeah.
Point difference, 1.4%.
like 97.4 average with quite a few misses.
Yeah, and Rhea actually being really, really good here. This is an amazing performance for Rhea.
Chat, we have to talk. What did I say before we started the match? We do not bet for the USA.
Only for the underdog.
For Austria.
Always.
Do not bet for the USA. That's cowardice. All right?
No sense of adventure, nothing.
Have you heard me? We do not bet for the USA. Stop it. Anyway, let's see what Austria picks. And
Wait.
Affiliate Reckon.
Oh, right. Yeah. Austria picked hell above. I confused it. True. Like, United States banned first. That makes sense. And we are seeing that cool pick has been replaced by Tornado, which is not a huge surprise.
Yeah. Tornado, just the speed demon against Serret, Garsh, and Estrella just staying in.
All right. Starting with the fastest map in the entire pool. Yes. Everyone knows Affiliate Requiem, I think. It's starting out slow, and then when the microwave noises basically come in, it's going to go nuts.
You know what? And Beat Saber did it to me. I think the microwave noises and everything, still, this is a gem.
I kind of agree, and I can't believe I say this.
Yeah, I don't understand. But
Rhythm Grain just break you. You just listen to it that much that you just start to like it.
Okay, so are we gonna see full combos like for the whole team at USA?
Ooh, that's a difficult prediction.
Okay, before I do that, let me see who's betting for the US and who's 1% Austria, guys, seriously.
I'm being told Serret's trails are like the default trails with his trails. That kinda is not great.
Yeah, that's true.
That's like I think that he probably uses custom sabers then. I thought that bug was fixed. That's really unfortunate. Yeah, he's definitely noticing.
Still keeping a 96.5.
Yeah, the entire team. Yeah, we can see. I think Serret's accuracy is dropping quite a bit because of the trails. Uni has missed right there, and Rhea too. Both at the pretty much exact same time. And meanwhile, Underswing just doing as I told, just holding that consistent comboing. You know, just really good at that. But accuracy wise, you know, holding full combo with a 94.6 is pretty much like 2% below what the US can do. So yeah,
not up there. Still,
yeah, the thing is,
really impressive.
It's really impressive, especially the thing is, I don't think his act drops off if it gets faster. Like on 350 BPM, I think it's the same accuracy. It doesn't change. That's what makes him very, very scary. And you can just see like the swings; they are so wrist heavy.
Yeah.
Like very,
there
very
are those
similar.
Players that just, it's a double-edged sword because you get faster, you still have the same hack, so it gets more and more impressive. But at the same time, you get slower and you keep the same hack, and that's kind of unfortunate.
It is, especially on
maps
like this.
Yeah, with the 95.3 with a miss.
Yeah, two misses even. Two misses. Rhea's accuracy is really good on this.
Gaining.
Alpha has a few troubles on this map. I think lots of misses on the windows.
Yeah, not quite a speed.
I'm assuming that like he was probably like I'm assuming that he was not the main pick for this, because I think it was Spylet who wasn't probably not here.
Oh,
right,
that's probable.
So yeah. You know, considering that Spylet also has is also a WGG member, I think like that. Yeah. Kind of predestined him for speed, but you know, this is we are actually not seeing a full combo on the US side because Tornado missed right at the end. I didn't even notice. All right, we are going to see two more bans now, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah,
so I think US Extreme is gone, so banning the accuracy maps. Yeah. Okay, also you're being honestly not also not really surprising, but we are going to see
that makes sense.
A pick by Austria, and honestly, I would assume that maybe.
United States. Oh no, never mind. Sorry.
Yeah, I think the order was not quite correctly written here, but the results are the same. I'm wondering if maybe Austria just goes for like Kiss Me More now.
So yeah, okay, that makes much more sense. USA picking the other fast map. They did affiliate reckon, so why not do Rebel Lurchers too?
I don't know, sometimes something comes up in real life and you can't really, you know, can't really do anything about it.
That's exactly what I mean. Look at Toppa. Just butter.
But I'm seeing a lot of default trails again. For Petotpa for Serret.
Oh yeah, you're right.
That's unfortunate again, but I think these two are the only ones. But these swings are indeed quite nice. And Petotpa also someone playing with lights. It's not something you see every day.
Ooh, tornado missing.
So Alpha has also missed pretty much at the same point.
Yeah.
Everyone else still
again,
holding
I think
strong
that
here.
You're right. He's probably a substitute for Spillet. I don't think it's... this is his expertise.
Yeah, it's not quite his speed. So Alpha is probably there for mid speed and not really for the speedier parts of the map pools.
And of course the US just went for the throat with it.
Yeah, this is like... Oh, Serret actually missing. Just dropping. I was going to say Serret holding the 97 here, but... there goes that, I guess.
Give him a second. I guess.
I would be surprised if he can bring it back up, honestly.
Yeah.
That would be really, really impressive accuracy. Especially like with default trails, right? Rhea has also missed, so... Oh, Uni has also missed. So no more full combos on Austria's side anymore.
Rhea just dropping everything.
Ooh. Oh, God, 11 misses.
He lost tracking or something.
Yeah, well, that's not great. That brings, like... only Petotpa and Estrella as the full combo holders here.
Man, I just can't get in on the Petotpa's swings.
They
like,
do
his
swings
like his wings like he's playing like ack. He's so slow.
Yeah, it's very, very nice and controlled. That helps a lot with actually the swings going where you want them to go by having that control. Underswing picking up a second miss. Rhea also has a little bit of trouble there. But in the end, you know, the point difference between the teams is almost at like it's even over 2% here.
Yeah. By the way, started climbing back up to a 96.88.
Yeah. That's...
Not quite a 97, but. Okay.
This is really insane.
Also Tornado, after missing at the beginning, 96.6. I mean, what do you even say? And Uni, by the way, still keeping, not even a full combo, and still a 95.
Yeah, he's that's
very,
really...
He was
really
very
good.
Happy with it.
But... Oh yeah, there we go. You were correct with your assessments, and honestly, I don't really sweat it, because this song is absolutely amazing.
Yes.
And that always gives a bonus to every tourney,
yes.
Having good songs.
This is probably my favorite song of the bunch, yeah.
It still has a lot of windows and bombs resets. That hasn't changed. So, you know, considering it's hackable, we are seeing, like, the mid-speed monster team for the US. And, like, again, the same team except for Underswing, who has been swapped out by Ori for the mid-speed maps. Yeah, they think the longest is actually Emanation. Yeah. Alright, so currently the highest scores on this map are 97.84 by Serret.
And 98.2 keeping right now.
Yeah. Sorry. So, but this is right in the beginning.
Yeah, it's slow.
It's going to get very like very difficult to not very difficult to egg, but more difficult to egg somewhere down the line. And we can see, like, look at Soul Alpha right now, holding that high 96. Now it's gonna drop a little bit, but you can see, like, on mid speed, Soul Alpha is holding his own. It's just this, like, speed is just not his strength.
And I personally can feel it. Like, it's exactly the same thing for me. At a certain speed, I just don't work anymore. Even under a certain speed, I just don't work anymore. And everybody has their own comfort zone. And look at him, keeping a 96.
Yeah, and let's also look at Rhea. Rhea holding a 97.2. That's insanely good. So Rhea definitely, like, on mid speed and probably, like, not probably, definitely on accuracy as well, is going to be like the big carry of the of Austria. Like, holding a 97.3 on this, that's like, honestly, if like Rhea would switch sides for some reason and play for the US, it wouldn't be like that big a difference, right?
So yeah, no, it's really strong.
So at this point, everyone is probably going to drop some accuracy. Lots of big windows, lots of stacks, diagonal stuff. This one is definitely the most hardest, the hardest part of the map. Yeah. Oh, and Saren missing also, there. Dropping quite a bit.
He's going back to his November 2020 days, where he would get a lot of number ones with one miss.
Still works. I mean, okay, it doesn't quite work because Kupik kind of exists now.
Yeah.
but still, like, holding a 97.4 with a miss, you know, that's still really, really good. So Alpha missing for his second time. Yeah, it's really insane. But that's like, it's not a, like, at this point, it's really not a surprise anymore. No, we are well aware of the skill levels of the players. Yeah. So, and we have seen this before.
What is gonna be interesting, even against the US, is see countries like Canada and the UK face against them, which is gonna be an uphill battle for anyone. All right,
definitely.
It's not gonna be even. I don't even think a fair match, to be honest, even against them. It's probably gonna be an uphill battle.
Probably not. Yeah. But I do think, like if of any team, the UK and Canada, they have the biggest chances.
Yeah, 100%. UK this year just really, really scary.
UK is indeed quite scary.
Has done their homework.
Brock has always done his own work.
Yes, and
that's just part of who he is.
Very, very good boy, and they're ready for it. And there, man, I'm excited.
Uni dropping to a 96%. Rhea holding that 97.12%. But in the end, it is not quite enough. Even if Austria had four Rhea's, this wouldn't have been enough.
GG. Everybody who voted for Austria, you are my friends.
Yeah, definitely.
I appreciate you. Koss, I see you voted for Austria, and I appreciate you too.
I have also voted for Austria.
You see, you were already appreciated before, now even more.
Now even more.
Yes, yeah.
So
yeah,
I think the next matches are going to be like way closer and way more competitive for Austria. And I'm looking forward to seeing that because like they have shown that they can perform really, really well. And, you know, if they are with the full roster, I think, honestly, like you gotta be careful not to slip up.